Adesso quando si siede in quadro.
SB Research Group.
Vai.
Ecco. Natalia Caramella.
Allora. L'ultima pagina. Eccoci qua. Allora, questo è 03-03-2018. E questo copia nostra. Questa è già la prima. Questa è già la prima.
So Natalia Tarabella, with report on role of sound in human life, and maybe not only sound but also silence. So welcome.
Good morning. Good morning. I will speak about the archaeoacoustic analysis of the Pyramid of Bomarzo in Lazio. During the 9 months of gestation, the fetus perceives the pulse of the maternal heart. It is the first sound that human hear still listens before seeing the light, a sound with a constant rhythm that will be part of the genetic heritage. It's the beat that marks life. From the first hominids on Earth, this patrimony was the guarantee for their survival. The smell, the sight, and above all the hearing were surely amplified and transmitted to animals with which they shared the other space. Living in symbiosis with nature, devoid of any form of pollution, perceived sounds, ultrasounds, vibrations, and energy fields instinctively. By the time they learned to refine their perception and gain greater reception power of the energy emanating from a place and the effect on the human body. The copper boulders coloring in stone are probably the first attempt to obtain a sound hitting the big rocks, the other stone taken in the hand, working as transducer. The dug holes carved in the rock worked as little musical boxes. Archaeoacoustic is not a new science, but a complementary approach to archaeology. It is a new perspective to analyze archaeological sites, which sometimes have interesting sound characteristics, and also the study of all physical phenomena. It is possible to measure the frequency of natural sound and magnetic field of archaeological sites and to interpret a possible sacred function. Natural sound phenomena have been used to create suggestive rituals in many civilizations. The pyramid, the Tachiolo Valley in Viterbo, is full of ancient stone artifacts, including the so-called Pyramid of Bomarzo, sculpted in a single block of rock and about 60 meters high. probably is dates back to the Rinaldonian period, a civilization before the Etruscan that had great skill in work in the stone and whose homes were built in the rock and near water source. Frontally, the structures look like a large altar with a series of steps that climb up to the top and spaces carved into the stone. There are two areas carved in the rock, on the right and the left side, with large step in the first in the middle, which led to the high place of the structure. The hypothesis of the cult function of the clay through the use of water is supported by the presence of a quadrangular stone basin overlooking the pyramid used for the sacral ablution. Thus, the sacrificial nature of this rise is not asserted, but over the century this mystical structure has survived the passage of religious syncretism and has always preserved its original sacred function. In addition to proceeding to the comparative archaeoacoustic analysis of the cup place above the so-called fine structure, we wanted to examine the rock structure itself. We therefore tried to detect the presence of infrasound, but we also realized that we could stimulate the resonance present in the room, but with a male voice and with a shamanic drum. The structure whose entrance is oriented perfectly to the east, apparently raised to level, even if the attic that divides it into two rooms in all is no longer present. The sound analysis of the recordings taken on the Pyramid of Bomarzo show infrasounds at the base of the pyramid, whose main dominant is represented by 14 Hz, a medium volume. This sound probably is due to the movement of groundwater. At the top of the pyramid, the sound change extends itself with a wider peak from 7-8 Hz to 14 Hz, already detected at the base. In Finestraccia, from the graph, we see that the shamanic drum stimulates the resonance at about 19 Hz, 97-98 Hz. This responds by releasing sound energy tank thanks to the superior harmonic of the drum. This sound energy is added to the upper harmonic of the drum, thus generating a higher peak. The presence of 14 Hz, even if a different volume, is a characteristic we have encountered in other sacred sites during the researches, where it was also possible to find a magnetic field as powerful as the one in the Pyramid of Bomarzo. 14 Hz have a strong effect on brain waves, inducing a state of relaxation. How is that millennia ago the Rinaldonians, the Etruscans, and the ancient Romans managed to find the sacred place without using the measuring devices we have today? The Roman architect had a deep knowledge of the vibration coming from the subsoil and possessed a particular category of prize called egors. They had the ability to detect such vibration using various methods of divination. Egurs are associated with the interpretation of the flight of the bird using a characteristic stick with the tip bent like the handle of an umbrella called litium. The powerful magnetic field present on the Pyramid of Bomarzo is, however, a topic still to explore. The hypothesis is that it's the shape of the pyramid structure that acts as an amplifier of a pre-existing natural phenomena. Some type of frequency modifies the nervous activity. In fact, the ancient sacred place were not for anyone, but only for people who began special meditation. It is very important to understand the relationship between these ancient sites and the people who build them. So archaeoacoustics should not only analyze the acoustic property of the site, but also all the physical phenomena associated and not perceived by human ear, which could have influenced the archaic population, is considered a particular place as sacred.
Grazie.
Thank you for your attention.
It's quite amazing how why this spectrum of usage of digital technologies in all